So I just finished watching the second episode of Star Trek Discovery, and once you watch the second episode, it's...
Pilot Part 2!
It's Pilot Part 2. And
yeah.
They're like, at the end of it, they showed the preview for the rest of the season, which makes it very clear, the pilot is...
Was a two-parter, that was a two-hour episode that should have, if you're showing episode one, show all of episode one.
And this is important because it debuted live on CBS, but they only played half of the pilot. Because it, like, it, this is so important to understand. It's a two-part pilot, and they only showed half of it on live TV, which is just bonkers. I don't understand what they're doing with their strategy to get people to trust the show, to like the show, by putting it behind a paywall. By when they debuted the first episode, it was preempted by football. So they picked a time slot that it was likely to get pushed back, and then they took a two-part episode and only showed half of it to people.
And they didn't even bother with going, you know, hey, it might get pushed back, so let's build extra time into our schedule. No. I left a going away party for a friend who is leaving and probably never moving back so I could start watching this on time. And what did I do? I sat here for 30 minutes just talking
playing
back
cards.
And playing cards while we
I guess
waited.
They were playing cards. We shot a video.
Yeah, we shot a video. But still, we wasted 30 minutes of time that I could have spent saying goodbye to my friends. Instead, I left early because... I had made a promise to come watch this at 7:30, not 8.
So, to state the obvious, we're coming straight from watching it. We're a little frustrated by what transpired, what the show was like, and just the whole build-up to it is just a little annoying. So let's move past that, just try and evaluate what we saw, and I'm going to add into that even what they previewed for what the season's going to be, because that ties into some of what we said in our criticism of the first episode was... I don't understand what they're doing with this that's different from what we've seen before.
Yes.
And I think if you see this, view this whole thing as a pilot, two-part pilot, and then they show the preview for the rest of the season...
It makes more sense.
It makes so much more sense, which that's why we started off with that weird rant about how this is a two-parter, because we shot a video that I was like, what...
What? Where are they going with this? How is this actually an interesting Star Trek show that's, like, new?
So it
made no sense in the Star Trek universe. And we're like, okay, how do we have the rest of the series where she's actually in Star Trek? And we're like, I don't understand.
Yeah, and likewise, just as a YouTuber making videos that try to make sense, I wouldn't have shot two videos if I'd known this is the way it was going to play out.
Yeah.
So many things that are just annoying about how they... I don't understand who's making the decisions as to, not the creative ones, because we'll have differences on should you, how much you change, purist, the creative decisions. We'll get into that in 20 seconds. But the way they're releasing this, the way they're announcing it, the way they're promoting it, the way they're handling all the details of it.
Yeah,
like from before I'm even watching the episode, I'm annoyed.
Like the way they built it up, they were like, we're going to be able to do things we've never been able to do before in the Star Trek world because we won't be on broadcast television and all this stuff, which made me go, oh, great. It's the first Star Trek that I will never be able to watch with my kids. And at least for the first episode that was solely shown on All Access, there was no problem showing it to my kids. I mean, there was
weird.
Yeah, there was inconsistencies that my 10 and 12 year old were able to point out. From their only having watched Deep Space Nine, they've watched all of Deep Space Nine, they've watched parts of Next Gen and parts of the original series. So just from that and having seen a lot of the movies, they were able to point out inconsistencies, which says you're not doing a good job writing if a 10-year-old can pick it out.
So anyway, so with the episode, it picks up obviously right after the last one because it is the last one. They're the same episode.
Yeah, same episode.
And in this one, immediately, our first officers put in the brig, and it's basically a war episode for the whole thing. Battles going on, miscommunications, ships blowing up, and then ships ramming other ships, and other things like that happening, and all sorts of once again, not feeling like Star Trek, and not feeling like. The sense of discovery, the very name of the show. And the first scene of it is this, let's go to a planet and discover things. And then it goes straight to a war episode for the rest of the pilot.
Yes.
And then we get into the last section of it where they beam over there. That doesn't make any sense once again.
Yeah. they're not keeping consistent with the setup. Okay, so they do this big build up. Klingons are all about honor. We, you know, that's the big thing we know about Klingons. They are embrace honor. And so
one of your kids had an opinion on that, didn't they?
Yeah, he had a very strong opinion on that.
I didn't like it because of how they changed the Klingons. It seems like they don't have honor with how they sneak attacked.
I despise it because the Klingons, the evil Klingons.
Hmm. Well, they were in the other shows too. Do you despise those as well?
Yes.
Fair enough. Logical consistency. Vulcans would be proud.
They have this bit where the Klingons were all about honor, and then they agree to a ceasefire, and then boom, right after that, I'm going to show you that I cannot just cloak, make my vessel invisible, which, by the way, they didn't have that technology yet. But I can still do this. And then he rams the Starfleet General's vessel, Admiral's vessel. Where is a sense of honor in that? Where is the code of honor that they just made the big deal of? And it was so stupid. And yeah.
And then likewise, shouldn't the final little act of it, Captain First Officer beam over just the two of them to try and capture the guy.
Yes.
And get into some scuffles with some Klingons. So it's two women fighting Klingons.
Yeah. Okay. So first off, we beam over and like they shoot it and like... we immediately start into this dialogue of, oh, it's like Stargate. The weapons act exactly like the weapons on Stargate. So we start joking, are they going to shoot him two more times and make the bodies disintegrate? Because there was a great joke on the Wormhole Extreme episode of, oh, you shoot him once, it stuns them. Shoot him twice, it kills them. And the third time, their bodies just disintegrate. They didn't do that, but, you know, the whole plan was we were going to capture this guy to humiliate him. And what is the very first thing she does after her captain dies? Kills him. Like, she could have still stunned him. Like, that was still the number one priority. And for somebody who supposedly is this super logical, raised by Vulcans person, she immediately cranks her phaser up and kills him. Like, and it's not internally consistent within Star Trek of... it's actually consistent with Star Wars tech of it burns a hole through his body. Like you can see the hole through his body from the phaser, which is not right.
Yeah. So I don't know. We kind of only been ranting about it because it's difficult to review based off what just kind of transpired. And so it's kind of more observations about different things. And then just kind of the plot of the episode, it was just a continuation of what happened before. It's not like,
yeah.
There's not like a plot to describe with a setup of it. So anyway, let's just kind of go based off where it left. Where it left the episode and the preview it gave did give me, I was optimistic when I saw the preview for the rest of it. Which is such a stupid, like, that just so frustrating. That would be my experience.
Yes. It felt like what you ended up with at the encounter at Farpoint type thing of it's not a particularly good pilot episode. So you're left going, okay, where does this go? And it doesn't look like it's going to have the feel of the rest of... actually, it's not going to have the feel of the rest of the series. So you have spent all this time building up... invest 2 hours building up investment in these characters who I think we have one other one besides our lead character who's sticking around. So they've spent all this time building up this interest
and
interaction behind it.
Weird.
And the Katra thing is nonsense. Does not make sense. And the whole idea of, so in Enterprise, they introduced the idea that they built on from the original series of a Vulcan and their mate are bonded. So you're supposed to have a telepathic connection over a vast distance. And they use that several times in Enterprise. But it's only supposed to be for their mate. It's not supposed to be for some random child that he found. And that was one of the weird plot points where they just randomly had Sarek communing with her telepathically at great physical cost.
Yeah. It's just, I'm just like, as it ended, I was like, wait a minute. Like, this feels like just entirely exist to give us expository information for what the actual show is.
Yes.
Like, the actual show begins with this third episode, and it feels like...
We just spent 2 hours on exposition.
Yeah. And if this was episode 9, and basically what they did was after episode 8, there's some sort of like cliffhanger type thing. Oh no, how did we get here? And we don't fully know the backstory of our lead character. And then it goes back and shows us this story, and we go, oh, now we know kind of what happened.
Yeah. Or start in media res and start it with she's already on the Discovery,
right,
and
right.
We have the whole thing of everybody hates her and they keep making reference to, oh yeah, you're the mutineer and we don't like you because of that. And then, you know, just show this story as like 5 minute, you know, pull an arrow.
Do flashbacks.
This is not a 2 hour premiere. This is the as flashbacks, it would have been great.
Right.
It would have been great as flashbacks to explain why it is everyone was so mad. And it would also work better for then pulling in the Sarek things. But instead, we have this 2 hour episode that is going to be in complete contrast to the rest of the season, as they have promised us the rest of the season. And that's the big frustration I think we both have of we just spent 2 hours going, okay, where is this going to go? Why is this adding anything to the Star Trek canon to only have them go, oh yeah, it's a bait and switch. We're not doing this after all. We just did this to set up that everyone hates her character.
Yeah, man, it's... I just so don't understand what they're doing. That's kind of the big thing
of all of this. Yeah, the big theme is, where are they going? Why are they doing this?
Which, and all of it goes back to kind of the bad buzz surrounding the show. They struggled to figure out what they wanted to do and the direction they wanted to go. And obviously they had big turnover with the showrunner.
Yes.
And change of directions, and he wanted to do something different. And so then you get a pilot episode that feels like a different show entirely. And then they show you, oh, no, this is what the real show is going to be. And you're like,
where did this all come from?
This kind of makes sense when you have a bunch of people in the writing room changing direction. I get it. So
yeah.
What's your final thoughts? We close out.
Final thoughts. I'm curious to see what's going to happen with our entirely new crew.
Yeah.
That we've never met before.
Yeah, now I'm excited to see the first episode of this new Star Trek show that's on Discovery.
That's on Discovery. It's called Discovery. But I don't... Yeah. I also was really struggling with the... It's a very dark tone, and as Sean mentioned in the last episode, at the last video, it's... Star Trek is not a dark show. No incarnation of Star Trek has ever felt dark and depressing, and this feels dark and weighs you down. And like, they had the trial scene, and they've done a lot of trials through Star Trek. I mean, I think pretty much every series has had some form of trial.
Orville has already had a trial.
They have? Oh. See, and in
every... very much like a matter of a man.
Measure of a man.
Measure of a man. And word of a man.
Yeah, so... They have had a lot of trial episodes, and every single trial episode, it wasn't the entire room is dark except for a spotlight on the accused. That's like we're going to do it in a medieval trial or the Klingon trial on Kronos.
Star Trek VI.
It's on like
we have seen it done before.
Yes, we did. You're right. And I'm like sitting there, and they've got the three people who are at the front, and I'm like, okay, well, it doesn't sound like Jason Isaacs, but I was half expecting that after they pronounced the judgment, the lights were going to come up. Surprise! It's Jason Isaacs! And they do a lot of basing Star Trek on a lot of things that we have here in the United States, like the right to face your accuser, you know, things like that. They don't do show trials. They don't have you standing in a spotlight where everyone else is in shadows. I mean, even when they did it in Into Darkness, where they had something of a what's going on here, they didn't do that. So, inconsistencies.
Yeah. So anyway, that's our take on it. How about you guys? Tell me down below in the comments section. I was following on Twitter kind of the whole ride while we were watching it, and the reaction to it are all across the board. Now, naturally, the ones that are getting a little bit more press are Star Trek's official Twitter and Star Trek Discovery's official Twitter and CBS's official Twitter, retweeting out the ones that
are positive. I'm shocked.
Shocking that that's what they're doing, but just searched for it, and there's a lot of people that were like, what? I'm not tracking with this. But I'd love to hear your take on it. I'm sure it's going to be a lively discussion.
And I had a friend who was already like, oh, this looks really promising. I'm super excited about it. Maybe I might get CBS All Access. And I was like, are we watching the same show?
Yeah, so anyway, if you're new to my channel, please consider clicking that subscribe button. I do movie reviews, TV reviews, like what you're watching. Yeah, right now.
Yeah, right now.
TV review. I keep saying review, which is not the way you say review. But that's what we do on this channel, and sometimes we make fun of ourselves and each other. But we don't want to just talk about movies and TV and make fun of ourselves. We want to do that with you. So join us in the comment section, and thank you so much for watching.